And y'all, that's how we have to wait. That's how we have to wait. When everything is going crazy around us, everything is going wrong around us, people look like they want to turn against you. Y'all do know David was a warrior, huh? Do y'all know how that could have turned out? Saul did kill his thousands, but David killed his tens of thousands. David was a killer. He started from a little boy. Oh man, people don't even get it sometimes.
Come on, Pastor.
People don't even get it. People don't even get it. But David was a killer. And when you hear somebody trying to kill you, what? He could have turned to himself.
Come on now.
He was talking about killing me. And he could have turned that anger against them.
All right.
Because his people was gone too. And you talking about killing me? But David didn't do that. David turned to God.
Amen.
And that's how we have to do, y'all. We can't, when we go through things in life, try to blame somebody else.
All right.
We don't look for the blame. Whatever you go through in your life, do not look to blame nobody about the situation. Find a solution.
Amen.
Find a solution.
Amen.
Everybody in here gonna go through something.
All right.
And if you fall after the flesh, you're gonna blame somebody.
All right. Amen. Come on.
You're gonna blame somebody. My wife got me in this. My children, y'all got me in this situation right now. Your friend, you know, should have been riding with you. You should have been riding with me. Your husband, is because of you. No, that's not how the Bible teaches us. The Bible teaches us through lessons and examples.
Amen.
David did not turn within himself. He did not pick some of his clothes, because you know David had some close homeboys. Everywhere you go, you're going to have some boys that's with you.
All right.
You know somebody else against you in the church, you know. The pastor, you know, somebody this side against him. He said, well, I'll get y'all to do some. You know, y'all got my back. I don't need you. Daddy taught me that a long time ago, and I was going to knock somebody out for him. I was going to meet them at the door after the meeting at church. So don't fight for me, son. Don't fight for me! God is my protector. God is my Lord. He's the one that got me. And if everybody was looking at a situation like that, whatever you're going through,
right,
if you wait on the Lord,
all right,
to be of good courage, he's going to strengthen your heart. That's what he's going to do. Your heart may be weakened by situations, by things that happen. Your heart gets weak.
Amen.
That's why God said, I'm your strength.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm your strong tower.
Yeah.
I got you.
All right.
I will never leave or forsake you. I will never leave you lonely. I will never.
Thank
even
you, Lord.
If you fall.
Thank you, Lord.
I won't utterly cast you down. I'm going to be there to pick you up.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
We serve a loving God.
Yeah.
We serve a loving God. And if we wait on him,
amen,
and be of good courage,
yeah,
he's gonna strengthen our hearts.
Oh yeah,
he's gonna give us a living moment.
Thank you, Lord,
to go on living further.
Yes, Lord.
He's gonna give us a living moment, because in this life is gonna keep on happening. He's gonna give you a living moment to go living further. He's gonna give you a living. That's where the endurance comes from.
Thank you.
It don't come from you, not your strength. Not your willpower, not what you got up here, not what you got in here. We don't got it all.
Thank you, Lord.
He got it all.
Amen. Hallelujah.
We have to learn to wait on him.
Wait on.
Wait on him. Wait on him as you're waiting at a window for him to come home. Wait on him at the door, wide open. Wait on him to come into your situation. Wait on him like you had this table. Sir, what else, sir? What else, sir? What else can I do? That's ministering, y'all.
Amen.
Y'all.
Amen.
That's waiting on the table. That's what we do while we wait. We serve God. Amen. We serve God as a servant. Wait on him. Just like he said he was coming. He's coming. Wait on him. And David reiterated, wait, I say, on the Lord.
Amen.
That's a beautiful song, y'all. Because when you read through it, do I have time to read through it right quick?
Come on, man.
Tell you what happened when David waited on the Lord. Let me show you what happened when David waited on the Lord. Amen. David could have took situations in his own hands, y'all. He could have turned and there'd have been some blood, a whole bunch of blood right there, y'all.
All right.
Oh, have mercy. And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of the people was grieved, every man and his for his sons and his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord. David waited on the Lord, y'all. That's Psalms 27 and 14. And David said to Abigail, to the ones that were 2 weeks ago, he gave it back to all of the towns that they were taken from. He just gave it back to everybody that he's seen in need, y'all. Y'all, we should have a good God.
Amen.
And we should have a spirit like the good God that we serve. Amen.
Amen.
We should wait on the Lord. Even when we go through our distresses, even when we go through our problems, even when we go through our situations, and people may be looking at us like we're to blame for it. But as long as you're walking with God, you're walking in the spirit, you're not fulfilling the lust of the flesh, you're walking circumspectly, you're walking waiting on Jesus to come back, you're walking looking towards the heaven for what's coming. So much,
thank
and we
you,
thank you for who you are.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you for bringing us back to life, oh God.
Thank you,
we
Lord.
Thank you for giving us life and giving it to